Why can you play basketball forever without getting bored? Because it's the same game, but it's never the same experience. Game developers use AI to do just that, but in a digital format. Same game, but new challenges, new experiences, new everything every time. That idea of same game, new experience is called procedurally generated content, and it's how we're going to build the future of entertainment. PGCs are basically just advanced algorithms created by developers. They're used in everything from old school games to some of the prettiest digital eye candy on the market today. And it's this set of algorithms that are programmed to create near infinite possibilities for anything and everything in games. PGCs make levels, they make characters, they make entire planets. You'd think infinity would be ridiculously complex to create, but it turns out it's simpler than you'd expect.
Simple systems can produce very surprising and interesting situations. Just a very simple game like basketball is partly about how just trying to throw a ball through a hoop with someone else who's trying to stop you from doing that ends up producing an almost infinite amount of complicated, interesting, surprising, dramatic, suspenseful situations.
PGCs are designed for human interaction, to create a more interesting and engaging experience for us, the players. Better PGCs mean games you can play forever. And the better we get at making those in the future, the more satisfying content we get to play. They'll work against you to make the game you're playing more challenging or unexpected. They might change how an enemy responds to you in battle. Or they may create 18 quintillion planets for you to explore.
AI researchers are kind of doing something similar. They're trying to understand what is the nature of intelligence. What are the methods that lead to an intelligent agent's capability to operate in the world, to have a goal and pursue it. That's the same thing you do in a game. We're presented with a kind of like series of complicated problems and the players are trying to solve them.
Because as humans, we don't like boredom. PGCs create scenarios that have infinite possibilities to respond to, which mean an infinite opportunity to never be bored. And that makes it almost like playing an entirely new game every time you turn it on.
That's what procedural, content generation offers us, right? As a new tool for exploring that sweet spot in between chaos and boredom on the other, right? Completely predictable boredom.
Game developers are always trying to figure out how to achieve these complex tasks with these simplest solutions. This is an entirely new frontier for our species to use AI in more creative and artistic ways.
I think No Man's Sky is very beautiful, but I think it's just scratching the surface of what procedural content can do. And if you look back at these earlier games like NetHack, it wasn't about the appearance of it, it was about their behavior. And I think if we can take some of the spectacular visual quality of a game like No Man's Sky and some of the kind of deep behavioral systematic interest and surprise from a game like NetHack, then we'll start to see some pretty spectacular things.
Games are an experimental minefield to see how AI can interact with all of us in a way that looks and feels natural. And the possibilities aren't literally endless, but they're pretty damn close.